It's the all-new Sports Visions with Dale Williams and DJ Jones, your 1980 national champions. 1980 and 81 SEC champions, two damn good dogs.
Welcome to the all-new Sports Visions. I'm DJ Jones alongside my good friend and traveling partner, Dale Williams. How are you?
What's up, player?
Hey, man, we switched it around a little bit just to get the shakes off of.
That's all right.
All right.
Switch it around.
Yeah, we're broadcasting from the SEC Media Days, the kickoff of officially SEC football, Dale, and we are on location at the Omni Hotel in beautiful downtown Atlanta. And I know that we are excited about being here and, of course, excited to share information with all of our viewers.
That's right, DJ, on the road with Sports Vision powered by Headquarter Nissan, doing it right here at the Omni Hotel.
Absolutely. We have an opportunity in just a little bit to tell you about the goings-on of SEC Media Day, and we also have an opportunity to, of course, sum up the Major League Baseball festivities. The teams have gotten rest. The Braves are going to be back on par this week. So we'll be interested in talking about that and a whole lot more coming up next on Sports Vision.
If you're even thinking about a new car, you've got to come to Headquarter Nissan.
Because right now, you can get the lowest payments of the year.
New Sentras from just $129 a month.
Altimas from just $159 a month.
And Rogues from just $169 a month. And all backed by our value plan featuring a lifetime warranty with an unlimited amount of time and miles and more. Lease for less. Columbus is a Nissan town.
E&S Men's Clothing Warehouse has been your most trusted name in men's fashion for more than 50 years. We've offered the area's best selection of top quality, name brand suits, accessories, and casual wear at the most competitive prices around. Customer service is our top priority. We're the professionals generations have trusted for the best quality and absolutely the best deals. We are E&S Men's Clothing Warehouse. We are simply the best.
Hello, everybody. I'm DJ Jones. You might know me from my athletic career at Carver High School, University of Georgia, or my sports broadcasting career. I know a lot of people. But when it comes to an attorney I trust, I call Forrest B. Johnson.
I'm Forrest Johnson of Forrest B. Johnson & Associates. I want to let you know how proud we are to be a part of your community, a part of the Columbus community and the Phoenix, Alabama community. Consider us first. When you or any member of your family has been involved in an automobile accident, remember, car wreck, get a check.
Call now, 706-223-5380.
Call now.
And welcome back to Sports Visions, Dale. It's SEC Media Days, and I know we've been talking about this for weeks out. Of course, we have the opportunity to broadcast on Radio Row for the very first time, making history, if you will, with the SEC, because 1985 was when they started the SEC Media Days in Birmingham, and that's where it has been until recently, moving it to Atlanta this year.
It's been big to move it to Atlanta, DJ. I appreciate the change. I think really the change is good. I think knowing that we heard a speech by Greg Sankey yesterday that it will go back to Hoover next year, but I think really it's going to be hard to pull this SEC Media Day out of Atlanta.
Absolutely. Great opportunity for Atlanta. Great opportunity for the SEC. This town is an international city, and the bottom line is that there's just so much more to offer. Not that Hoover wasn't a great place and not that we didn't have a wonderful time there, but you know what? The SEC and all of its growth and production, they deserve a city like Atlanta.
You know, the games that the city of Atlanta have, you know, Gary Stokes so eloquently told us yesterday that basically one of the biggest things, Atlanta is number three in the whole country, DJ, when it comes down to sports revenue and entertainment.
Absolutely. And again, the SEC in downtown Atlanta. Of course, you have the Super Bowl here, the national championship game. You're going to have all of these big events coming on. So why not the SEC? And again, talking about the commissioner and his words that he addressed earlier in the week, I like the fact that, you know, that there's so many championships, not just in football. Football is a powerhouse. However, you know, he mentioned the number of golf, he mentioned a number of other sports, golf included, women's softball, track and field. It's just a plethora of events that are top ranked nationally. And again, when you talk about overall ranking on paper, the SEC is the powerhouse in America.
No question, DJ. Again, every year they give us enough, enough ingredients so that we can go out and say, hey, how good the SEC is. This is why the SEC is the number one conference in college football, in all sports. And I think really the numbers that Greg Sankey gave us, DJ, you know, dictate that. You know, the one that stands out in my mind is that out of 21 sports, 14 of those sports, the SEC has been first place or second place in those sports. That's big, man.
It is huge. And again, you talk about college football, 10 bowl eligible teams out of 14. I mean, that is tremendous when you really think about it. But, you know, on a graduate level, when you think about academics in sports, he gave us the statistics, and I think it was something like 38 players had graduated and 3 players had their master's.
The Georgia-Alabama National Championship game, 38 players had already graduated with 3 of them already having their master's. That's big. You know, overall in all the sports, over 350 student athletes graduated last year, which was very big. But one of the other things that was really big, and we talk about other sports, every women's softball team made the NCAA tournament. Every one of them.
That's phenomenal. It is phenomenal in every sense of the word. But it's no secret why the SEC is having so much success now, because it was set on a really solid foundation. And when you talk about foundation, Mike Slive, of course, who was the commissioner prior to Sankey, Greg Sankey, I mean, he obviously had a vision. The SEC network was a vision. And that vision came to fruition, and that vision ended up making the SEC a lot of money with television deals through ESPN and others. But again, without all of that money, without all of that vision, you wouldn't see the great progress that you've seen amongst the conference with facilities, because again, as they collected this money that was obviously distributed on behalf of the SEC offices to all of the institutions, the 14 institutions, they have a ton of money to do different things with as far as helping their athletic programs and helping their the academic with
academic
building
enhancement.
Academic enhancement, exactly. So, you know, the whole thing is, man, this thing is huge, and it's going to continue to grow, and I don't see it stopping anytime soon.
I don't even, DJ, but really one of the good things about it, the SEC has a great legacy from the standpoint of the Roy Kramer piece. I think what Roy Kramer did was great, all the things that he did, DJ, but more so than any, the vision that Mike Slide painted on this whole SEC. And then with the SEC network basically made to enhance what people already know and see, it has made it such a big thing. And really, you know, for as money's concerned, like you said, you know, revenue distribution has been great. The power of all the teams that are in the SEC, whatever sport that is, the graduation ratio, diversity, all those things that Mike Sly talked about, you can see the fruits of the labor right now.
All right, we'll take a short break. This is Sports Features.
Watching a cow.
Oh, what's it doing?
Impressions.
Power up your morning with a new 300-calorie egg white grill. Only at Chick-fil-A.
If you're even thinking about a new car, you've got to come to Headquarter Nissan.
Because right now, you can get the lowest payments of the year.
New Sentras from just $129 a month.
Ultimas from just $159 a month.
And Rogues from just $169 a month. And all backed by our value plan featuring a lifetime warranty with an unlimited amount of time and miles and more. Lease for less. Columbus is a Nissan town.
You're gonna do great.
Thanks, Dad.
Brick a leg.
Aflac?
Not that kind of brick.
Oh!
That had to hurt.
Aflac?
Not that kind of hurt. Yeah, Aflac paid us cash in just one day to help with our car payments and mortgage.
Aflac!
Perfect timing! See how Aflac helps cover everyday expenses at Aflac.com.
This is Academy Sports and Outdoors. We offer a huge sports and outdoor selection of top name brand gear like you've never seen. All at low prices like you've never seen. Because we're a sports and outdoor store like you've never seen. Until now. Now open in Columbus, Academy Sports and Outdoors, for all for less.
Welcome back to Sports Visions, Dale. It's been a tremendous week, of course, here on Radio Row. Had been the opportunity to interview so many special people in this conference. And you know what? I'm proud of what we were able to accomplish.
I'm really am, DJ, and really even from the radio perspective, but really just being able to to meet and greet and sit down people, to interview them, and everybody was so willing to be interviewed that it made it real easy for us.
Just think about this, though. When we started out, we had, of course, Gary Clegg, Chip Towers, the Atlanta Journal-Constitution beat writer for the Georgia Bulldogs, and Eli Gold, the legendary voice of Alabama football, and DJ Shockley. Of course, we watched DJ over the past several years skyrocket in this industry, and it's just a plethora of people that we were able to share back with our radio audience back home.
I mean, really, that was big, DJ, even from the Gary Stokin piece, you know, even Robbie Robertson, you know, with the Colonnade group. Everybody that we have relationships with, we had an opportunity to sit down, have a great interview with them, DJ, comfortably, you know, even without the television cameras on, but at the same times, again, rekindling and restoring relationships that we have, because again, it's all about the relationships, player.
Indeed, and I know that you're going to enjoy these interviews as we unfold over our radio show, the Sports Visions radio show. If you hadn't had opportunity to tune in, you're going to get some of the best interviews that we've had in quite some time, because again, SEC Media Day, it had everybody coming under one roof in one building, and to basically share information. And you see in this room alone, there's 30 or 40 radio stations set up, and they've been rolling all week. And they too were able to capture some of the personality, some of the information, and take back to their community.
And, you know, really, again, I hope our community is just lifted and just know that, you know, what we are doing, you know, even though some people think we don't work these days, that we did a good job of working and bringing back the stories back to the Columbus and Chattahoochee Valley area.
Well, the ones that you said think we don't work, they obviously don't understand this business, because, again, when you're talking about doing a radio show, a television show, being in the mix of the SEC and at Media Day right here on Radio Row, it's just been sensational. And, again, the folks in the industry that understand what it's like to book these interviews, what it's like to actually set up and, of course, orchestrate and execute the actual shows, that's enough within itself.
You know, it's enough in itself, DJ, but one of the biggest things that I think sometimes we might overlook is that sometimes when you just go anyway without a script, and in the natural and just in the spirit, a lot of good things happen, and a lot of great things happen with us. I mean, the Kirby Smart interview, I mean, really, we didn't plan for that interview, right? But I think that was probably one of our better interviews that we talked to and were able to talk back, and hopefully everybody in Columbus, you know, heard the interview that we did. But I think really just to see the players that he brought, DJ, and that, again, they have bought in. They emulate him. I think really that speaks volume, and to feel the comfort that Kirby is getting in. I think he's walking in a little comfort area just a little bit, DJ, and I think really he's believing in what he really wants to bring to the University of Georgia.
Indeed it is, and again, we're hopefully that you'll have the opportunity to see all of these wonderful, or not see, but hear all of these wonderful radio interviews that we will have, because it's been a terrific week, a terrific 4 days, Dale. And I'll tell you what, I think this is probably one of our better trips as far as work trips.
I mean, I think so, DJ, and what we always tease each other about is that this was good, but we even got better in us. But I think really to know the resources that we do have, DJ, and just seeing that vision come to fruition, that we can do some great things with our TV format.
All right, we're going to take a short break. This is Sports Visions.
Building wealth is an innate desire we all possess. Whether you're raising a family, running a business, or starting a career, the best commitment you can possibly make today is to build wealth for your future. Now, more than ever, our innovation teamed with a personal approach to building wealth is the win we both are striving for. Trust in our commitment to help get you there. Citizens Trust Bank. A relationship you can bank on. Member FDIC.
This is Academy Sports and Outdoors. We offer a huge sports and outdoors selection of top name brand gear like you've never seen. All at low prices like you've never seen. Because we're a sports and outdoor store like you've never seen. Until now. Now open in Columbus, Academy Sports and Outdoors, for all for less.
Hey, Devin here, head coach of Nissan. I'm here with Erin. She's going to talk about this event that we got coming up that we really need your support. So, Erin?
All right, Devin, thank you. So on July 28th, actually the whole month of July, we are honoring and wrapping our arms around teachers. So what we have going on, if you are a teacher, you can come to Headquarter Nissan during the month of July, show your ID badge. If you spend over $50 in our service department on a repair order, we're going to, number one, give you 15% off that day's service. So that's big for our teachers. And also, while you're here, you can, we have a Titan in the showroom that's already getting stuffed with school supplies.
That's right.
We're doing that for teachers, so bring in a donation. You can enter to win a 50-inch smart TV just by coming in and making a donation. Here's the other little part of that. We are going to award a Titan Teacher of the Year on July 28th. Go to WTVM.com, nominate a deserving teacher. We're going to give them a gift card for $500 toward their classroom supplies. We'll pull that winner on July 28th, and their school, the winning teacher's school, is going to get the entire contents of that Titan truck school supplies.
So we don't just do deals. We also give back to community.
That's right.
Headquarter Nissan, we stay in the community. We support everybody, military, vets, and now teachers. So come on out to Headquarter Nissan, where it's the home of the lifetime warranty. We got you get $2,500 if you just, your car gets stolen. You get key replacement. We got all kind of deals. We got stuff for everybody. We always have all kind of events. And Aaron, tell them about our Friday event.
All right, so every month we pull one winner to win a prize. We've got iPads, NutriBullets, TVs, George Foreman grills. All you do for that is just come in, enter to win right here, stick your name in the ballot. The first Friday of each month, we pull one winner. I mean, it's just too easy, y'all.
So come on out to Headquarter Nissan. You get a deal, you get a deal. Everybody get a deal at Headquarter Nissan.
Welcome back to Sports Visions. Dale, we have had an opportunity to hear from all 14 coaches here, but more importantly, let's break it down for our viewers right there, all of our Alabama, Auburn, and Georgia folks. You know, let's start with Kirby Smart. Kirby came in and, you know, realistically, we noticed a calm about him this time around. Again, you know, obviously after winning the SEC and having an opportunity to play in the national championship game, gave him, I guess, a sense of comfort and understanding that maybe he was doing what he needed to do, and he delegated and put people in places so that he didn't have to worry so much.
Well, you know, DJ, that's one of the best things that can increase your comfort level, man, you know, winning. Again, we always talk about winning, being comfortable, guys believing in your program, doing the things that needs to be done to be successful. I think all his players, I think the Bulldog Nation believes that. And I think everybody believes those expectations now.
Absolutely. And again, you know, very, very proud of the young men that he brought through. We had an opportunity to see Jonathan Ledbetter as well as interview, you know, Terry. And again, when you talk about J.R. Reed, you know, just a tremendous kid. I had forgot that he had transferred in from Tulsa, but he's going to be one of the leaders on the back end at the safety position, and he did a great good. Terry Godwin from right there and where, you know, right around in our area from out of Callaway High School, he is going to be a leader amongst superstars. I think he'll have a superstar group of receivers, and it's great to know that Terry Godwin has played, and Kirby mentioned that he had been knowing Terry since middle school.
That's right, and really, you know, again, going back to Kirby Smart again, recruiting is very important. But when you know a kid from the eighth grade to now his senior year in college and you've been with that guy, the mentoring process kicks in, DJ. And that's one of the biggest things that I saw with all these coaches. They mentor their players emulate them. But the three that Georgia brought, I was really impressed with. They are a true meaning of being student athletes.
And, of course, in summing up Georgia, the bottom line is, yes, yeah, they lost some great seniors, especially the running backs and the outside linebackers are going on to the next level. But, you know, it's next man up. They got some young guys, and the quarterback situation, it's going to play itself out. But we know that Jake Fromm, for the most part, is going to be the guy that they're going to be counting on to lead the troops. Justin Fields is a guy that I know he's going to get some action. Hopefully it's not because of an injury to Fromm, but because he's able to add another dimension to the offense. Let's skip over to Auburn Tigers. Gus Malzahn, you know what, it's always good to see Gus. It's hard to believe that he's been at Auburn 9 years.
Man, really it is unbelievable that he's been there for 9 years, and we've been right there with him, DJ, and there's a lot of good things that have happened to Gus. I mean, even though he's been there 9 years, in my spirit, sometimes I feel like they don't even appreciate him yet. And really, he's an LSU game away. They're trying to run him away.
Absolutely. But you know what? The work is in. Auburn is rated fairly high. They're, you know, in the top three in the conference. However, their schedule has to be probably the toughest in the conference. But again, Gus feels good about his football team, especially his quarterback, Jarrett Stidham. who is just a very talented young man, and hopefully that offense can get going, because that defense that he has is going to be strong.
It's going to be strong, DJ, and DJ, I'm going to tell you something. I think Auburn's just going to be just as good, probably in the top six or seven teams in the country. I think the opening with Washington is going to be a good test and going to be able to tell us a little bit more about these guys. But, DJ, they beat Georgia last year. They beat Alabama last year, DJ. And really, they probably were a running back away from doing some greater things.
Speaking of running backs, the last 9 years been – 1,000-yard rusher has come from the Auburn Tigers football team. It's an SEC record, but just to think, it's just tremendous. And, you know, when we talk about the 9 years that Gus has been there, the first two as an offensive coordinator, but the last actually seven as the head coach, you know what, it makes you feel – I never thought about that, but that's a tremendous accomplishment when you talk about an offensive football team.
You know, really, and Gus is a offensive guru. I think, really, he does a great job with his Auburn offense, being wide open, no huddle, fast pace, always up-tempo. I think he does a real good job with that, DJ, and I think one of the biggest things that people have to realize is that Auburn will – this year, Auburn has a lot to prove. And, again, I think really for us being in the SEC West is big. But, DJ, Auburn's going to be real good this year.
Good luck to Gus Malzahn and the Auburn Tigers. Now, last but not least, the Alabama Crimson Tide, the reigning national champs. I know that when we were talking about when the SEC Media Days was held in Hoover, the rock star following that Nick Saban had, and, of course, we were waiting to see how it came about here in Atlanta. Although we're spread out and a lot of the media, or at least a lot of the fans, can't get around as they did over in Hoover. But you know what? Nick came in with his swag and he delivered his message. And of course, I like the fact that right off the bat, he pulled off and said he had a disclaimer for everybody. He didn't want to talk about his quarterbacks because he wanted to let everybody know he hadn't made a decision yet and it's to be determined.
To be determined. And really, that was the tone of his speech, and, you know, to diffuse whatever controversy that there is with the quarterback situation. He wanted to diffuse that right off the bat. Did a great job. Now, Nick's the man of control in the press conference, so he knows very well how to do this thing. But really, for us looking at Alabama, some of the question marks that they might have, DJ, they always have a tough schedule. Opening game against Louisville, turn around and play Texas A&M, Tennessee within the first five games of the year. But I think really they're groomed for it, DJ. They've always been groomed for it. And Ria, they got a lot of kids that they graduated and got a lot of seniors that are not there anymore. But I think, DJ, they got the Jimmys and Joes. They got five stars. They got guys that we just don't know their names yet. I believe in that, and I think Alabama will be right back in the mix of things this year.
Now, my concern is on the secondary, losing five players. Again, you know, of course, the most important, Micah Fitzpatrick, to the National Football League. You got a new crew back there. And, again, I know that that's one of the specialties that Nick has as coaching up the secondary. But, again, those are the concerns. Now, up front, it's a different thing. And, again, you know, when you got those guys up front coming and putting the pressure on that you need, those guys on the backside don't have to cover as long.
Don't have to cover that long. And I think that is going to be the defensive game plan, to get after guys up front, blitz, pressure. Alabama always has pressure defense anyway. But I think to protect probably a young secondary, DJ, they're going to do a little bit more than what they've done in the past. But I think one of the biggest things about them, man, they know how to manage the ball. They know how to control the game. The Damian Harris piece is going to be big. I'm going to put him in the Maxwell Award piece. But also, DJ, I got to put him in the Heisman piece because, you know, if Alabama has a good offensive line, this guy, he could do 2,000 yards this year.
We mentioned before that these three teams, Alabama, Auburn, and Georgia, are picked coming out of SEC Media Days as the top teams in the SEC. However, I'm going to say it right now. I think we're going to have a repeat. Actually, not a repeat in the SEC championship game this year. I'm picking Georgia and Alabama to compete for the SEC championship game in Atlanta.
Yeah, just like I told Eli Gold yesterday, I see him December 1st for, you know, round two of Georgia and Alabama. I think those are the two teams that are going to be there. I think the SEC media writers picked those two teams to be in the SEC championship game. I'm gonna agree with them on that. But really, at the same time, DJ, I know there's some surprise teams in the SEC when you start talking about, again, Florida, South Carolina, Texas A&M, Auburn. I think those are going to be a dogfight as usual in the SEC.
Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.
Sports Vision, sponsored by Aflac, Chick-fil-A, Mel and Abe's, Styles by Denise, Jordan Girls, Taylor Funeral Home, Horace B. Johnson and Associates, State Farm, Jimmy Watts Agency, and Dr. Jamie Winchester.
Building wealth is an innate desire we all possess. Whether you're raising a family, running a business, or starting a career, the best commitment you can possibly make today is to build wealth for your future. Now, more than ever, our innovation teamed with a personal approach to building wealth is the win we both are striving for. Trust in our commitment to help get you there. Citizens Trust Bank, a relationship you can bank on. Member FDIC.
Every remaining 2017 Nissan must go, so they're all priced to sell.
Titan, buy from just $21,130.
Ultimas, just $19,900.
Rogues, just $19,800. All backed by a lifetime warranty and more.
Hurry
before they're gone.
Hello, everybody. I'm DJ Jones. You might know me from my athletic career at Carver High School, University of Georgia, or my sports broadcasting career. I know a lot of people. But when it comes to an attorney I trust, I call Forrest B. Johnson.
I'm Forrest Johnson of Forrest B. Johnson & Associates. And I want to let you know how proud we are to be a part of your community, a part of the Columbus community and the Phoenix, Alabama community. Consider us first. When you or any member of your family has been involved in an automobile accident, remember, car wreck, get a check.
Call now, 706-223-5380.
Call now.
And welcome back to today's final segment of Sports Vicious Dale. These last 3-4 days that we spent here in Atlanta at the SEC Media Days has been tremendous.
Been great, man. This has been the best one, DJ. Attended-wise, I'm pro-Atlanta for the SEC moving here, moving everything here. I think there's a lot of things that they can do from a marketing standpoint, but more so than anything, the SEC TV piece, everything is right here. Big Airport, I think there's a whole lot more for us accommodating to the media. But again, Hoover's still in the mix.
Absolutely, and I think what the success of this event coming here, again, the takeaway is all the outstanding interviews that we had to take back to our radio family and share. And we're going to have just fun here these next few weeks leading into the season.
I mean, we got some great stuff leading into the season, even though we'll be doing our On the Road with Sports Vision powered by Headquarter Nissan, DJ. We're going to be able to reflect back to some of those radio interviews for us being on television, talk about some of those things, and break down each team in the SEC a whole lot more.
And, of course, this conference, as we always talk about, being the most powerful conference in all of college football, great thing is that, we got a commissioner that understands his coaches, he understands his athletic directors, and you're seeing it because of the great performance all across the board, not just in football, but in all sports.
In all sports, DJ, and one good thing, it means more, that SEC slogan. That is big, DJ, because even from the administrative standpoint, even from the coaching standpoint, the student-athlete standpoint, and how the SEC runs this business, it's all top shelf, and they really look for the best out of everything that they do.
All right. Well, that's going to do it for all the time we have for today's show. For Dale Williams, I'm DJ Jones, reminding you to keep your eye on the ball. Have a great week.
Be sure to check out our Facebook page, Sports Visions TV Show, or our website, www.sportsvisionsusa.com.